Okay, good evening guys. Welcome to the another session on floriculture on dahlia. Dahlia are one of the most important and popular flowering bulbs. With the different colors, shapes and size of dahlia brings the beauty and life back to the landscape in the later summer and autumn. Dahlias are extensively used for the purpose of exhibition, garden display and decoration purpose. I feel my voice and screen is visible. Voice is clear, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. Then I will continue. Then coming to introduction, for the border dwarf growing plants, that while large flower type pots are used here, then long stemmed flowers with which are excellent color and forms are used for the flower arrangement. In dahlia, the excellent cut flowers and dahlias are also used for the garland making. Then these tubers have the medicinal property due to the presence of appreciable quantity of insulin and fructose. You kindly remember the tubers possess the medicinal property. The chemicals responsible for that are insulin and fructose. You kindly remember these two compounds. Then coming to botany, the botanical name is Dahlia spectabilis, belongs to family Asteraceae. This is also the national flower of Mexico. The origin is Mexico or Central America. This is also the national flower of Mexico. This has to be remembered. And this is a perennial herbaceous plant with a tuberous root system. You remember this, tuberous root system. And type of inflorescence is capitulum. All the Asteraceae belonging species, the inflorescence is botanically termed as capitulum. Then the fruits are known as akins. This is also same. Then the modern chromosome number of dahlia is 2n is equal to 4n is equal to 64. The Dahlia spectabilis is tetraploid in nature. You kindly remember this one. Then coming to the origin and distribution, Mexico and Central America are the native place of wild species of dahlia. What do you mean by origin or native place? Means if the wild diversity or the wild species, the diversity is maximum in that particular place, means then the botanist will call this is the origin of that species. Like that, dahlia is basically originated from Mexico or Central America. In India, dahlia are introduced from 1857 under the patronage of Royal Agri Horticulture Society of India, Kolkata. You kindly remember this Royal Agri Horticultural Society of India, located at Kolkata. This is also important. They introduced the dahlia from Europe in the year 1857. The major contribution of our country is flower pot dahlia formation. These are the flower pot dahlia form. This is also one of the major contribution towards the dahlia production or with respect to breeding. Along with that, development of late cutting method of dahlia preservation. This is also important key point with respect to your JRF or SRF. Late cutting method of dahlia preservation. Kindly remember this, late cutting method is followed in which among the following of crops? Dahlia. If you cut the flowers at late, the waste life of the dahlia will be more than planted breeding. Then coming to species, Dahlia coccinea, then Dahlia pinnata. With respect to the species, I think there is no need to remember all these species and their chromosome number and their special characters. This is mainly for your knowledge purpose. Then Dahlia imperialis. This also called as tree dahlia. This is important with respect to objective type question. Dahlia imperialis is also called as tree dahlia. Then Dahlia tenicularis. Then Dahlia macdougallii. This is a climbing species. Then Dahlia Merakei. Then Dahlia Australias. then Dahlia, Rudis, then Tunis. Then coming to the varieties. With respect to varieties, here mainly the single flowering means they are mainly suited for the bedding purpose. These are the single type flowering varieties in Dahlia. Then anemone type, then colorated type, then water lily type, then decorative type, then gain decorative. These are mostly exploited in India. These are all popular in India. Most popular group and tendency to grow them large as possible in India. These are all the gain decorative type of dahlias. Then medium decorative, then small decorative. These are all mainly used in the garden display. Then miniature decorative, ball type, pompon type, cactus type, semi cacti type, peony type, mignon, top mix. These are all the important cultivars with respect to worldwide. Some of the important cultivars which are developed in India are Kenya Blue, Manali from, this is from IRI, Manali. Then Manjushri, Swami Vivekananda, Swami Ji, White Star, Lucky Star, Bikku. The Bikku series also comes in Dahlia. You remember Bikku series of Dahlia are bred in India. Then Swami Vivekananda, P.K. Das, A.K. Day. These are the important breeders who worked on Dahlia in India. Mainly Swami Vinayananda. Then with respect to climate. With respect to climate, the day and night temperature has a great effects on Dahlia flower production. The best quality flowers are obtained when they are grown in 25 degree Celsius day temperature and 16 degree Celsius night temperature. For the better growth and development, cool atmosphere and free from the frost is favorable. Then with respect to the daylight, short days delays the flower formation and induce the abortion and also the induce the tuberization. Hence Dahlia is quantitatively short day plant. You remember this one. Dahlia is comes under quantitatively short day plant. Then coming to soil type. Soil is mainly, it needs sandy loamy soil and pH ranging from 6 to 7. With respect to propagation, mainly through seeds, division, then stem cutting. Through seed, mainly September, October is the ideal time for sowing in the plain condition. Here for the seed germination, the specific temperature is required for seed germination, 18 to 20 degree Celsius. And here no seed dormancy is observed. This is also one of the peculiar character. In spite of the no seed dormancy, it needs the constant temperature of 18 to 20 degree Celsius for 1 week. Then only it will germinate. Then division. Here the multiplication by division of tuberous roots can be done by separating the tubers, each with a piece of stem. Care should be taken that each division should have at least one eye bud. These are the eye bud. I think you are familiar with these tubers of Dahlia. Is this audible?
The voice is not audible.
Now?
No audible.
Now audible, na? Due to power cut, the Wi-Fi gone. Now it's audible, right?
Yes, sir.
Screen? Screen visible?
Screen is visible.
Okay. We'll continue the propagation technique. This is mainly through division. Then the division of tuberous roots. This is the easiest and satisfying method of propagation in Dahlia. Then but commercially dahlia is propagated through stem cuttings, but easiest way is division. Here the growth of September October forms good cutting material. The terminal cutting of 7 to 8 cm length and 2 to 4 leaves are prepared. For any floriculture terminal cuttings, we need minimum of 7 to 8 cm length of terminal cuttings, then minimum 2 to 4 pair of leaves in order to survive. Then after the cuts are ready, they are treated with the IBA powder and the cuttings here. Internet is unstable showing. Voice is clear, right?
Now
yes, now voice is clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, the commercial method of propagation of dahlia is mainly through cuttings. You remember this one. Then with respect to land preparation, as followed in the other crops, then after the land preparation, we'll apply the manures and fertilizers. Then we'll go for the planting. The sprouted tubers are used for the planting in hills. The rooted stem cuttings are used in the plains. This one also important point, you kindly remember this one. Sprouted tubers are used in the hills, then rooted stem cuttings are used in the plains. Then with respect to irrigation, mainly done 3 to 4 days interval. Then with respect to weed control, this is also very important. The prominent weeds are sindon, cypress, these are all the important weeds. Then hoeing. Coming to intercultural operation, the hoeing is one of the important in dahlia. You kindly remember, hoeing intercultural operation comes under the dahlia flower cultivation. Dahlia plant should not be deeply hoed as it is surface rooting plant. The hoeing should be done at the interval of 10 days. Then mulching. Mulching, why they are mainly plastic mulch is done. It will enhance the growth and flowering and also tuber formation, and it also controls the weed growth. Then coming to trining, when dahlia plants grow from the sprouted tubers, only a strongest shoot will be retained and other will be removed. This is trining. Only the strongest shoot will be retained and other will be removed. Then coming to pinching. Pinching means 2 to 3 pair of leaves are removed. This is pinching. Then staking. Staking, this is mainly these dahlia stems are very brittle and liable to break. Hence they should be given the support with sticks or bamboo canes. Then tying with the any threads at the height of at 30 to 40 centimeter tall. Then pruning and disbudding is also one of the major intercultural operation in dahlia. The large decorative type varieties should have 4 to 5 branches. Then small flowering type should have the 8 to 10 branches. The number of flowers are regulated by disbudding, particularly for the large blooming types. Then coming to the plant growth regulators, the application of IAA and GA3 at 100 to 100 and 1000 ppm showed a marked difference in the growth of shoot length. Then with respect to pot cultivation, this is mainly for indoor cultivation, or these mainly the gain types are mostly grown here for the decorative type. Here the pot mixture will be loamy soil, FOM, leaf mold and 30 gram of bone meal. Then coming to important diseases in dahlia, mainly powdery mildew, then stem rot, then wilt by verticillium, then smut, then bacterial wilt due to pseudomonas. Then coming to important pests like aphids, leafhopper, European corn borer, then thrips, two spotted mite. These are the important pests. Then coming to important nematodes which affect the dahlia crop are root knot nematodes, then potato rot nematode. These are all mainly controlled using the hot water treatment of tubers. This is the effective way to control the nematodes. Coming to harvesting, it takes about 1.5 months from the appearance of central flower bud. 1.5 months is required. Then from bud to bud maturity to opening of flowers, it takes about 15 to 20 days. About 3.5 months from flowering to tuber. After the tuber is planted, 3.5 months is required to flower. Then they are harvested in the morning hours. Then coming to post harvest management, the dahlia are stored in at the 4 to 5 degrees Celsius at for the 3 to 5 days. Then coming to waste life solution, 10% of glucose, 0.22 mm of AgNO3, or 10% glucose plus 0.22 mm of AgNO3 plus 8 HQC at 200 mg per liter is used as a waste life solution. Glucose, AgNO3, 8 HQC. These are the main chemical components used in the waste solution. Coming to tubers, after flowering, the plants are cut around 15 cm above the ground level. We should not affect the crown level. If the crown is damaged, the whole tuber will rot. Coming to the storage of tubers, before storing the tubers should be retained with the 0.2% of Kapton for 30 minutes in order to avoid the fungal infections. Then we have to give the sufficient air circulation while we have kept in the bags. In the hilly condition, the tubers should be lifted during the October and November. These are the tubers. Coming to yield, with respect to pompon type of cut flowers, it yields 8 to 10 flowers per plant. Loose flowers, 15 to 30 flowers can be harvested from one plant. Then, voice is clear, right? You are there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I will spell out some of the important points from my short notes. Then usually the dahlia ray florets will be in many colors, but the disc florets are generally in yellow color. This is also one of the important point. The general color or the color observed in the disc florets of dahlia, which among the following is yellow, green, they may ask like that. Some of the important practices like stopping and thinning, hoeing, these are all disbudding done in dahlia. Mainly, how many buds are there in each branch? Mainly, there will be three buds in every branch. Only one will be retained, which is strong, and other will be removed at peanut stage. Disbudding, disshooting, these are all the some of the important intercultural operations. Then, as I told, this is a quantitative short day plant or facultative short day to day neutral plant. If they ask in the MCQ, if the option is there, quantitative short day plant, go for that. Otherwise, short day plant. This is a deciduous type of crop. And kindly remember, this is also important. Dahlia is deciduous. And this is tetrapod.
Sir, dahlia is deciduous?
Yeah. Deciduous means it will shed the flower, it will shed the leaves, vegetative parts while in winter season.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is deciduous in nature. You remember this one. Dahlia first introduced in India in the year 1857 by Agri Horticulture Society of India, where it is located in Kolkata. Then largest producer of dahlia are Netherlands. Then in India, mainly gain decorative types are popular. Where is the National Dahlia Society? National Society on Dahlia, where it is located? Any idea? Yes, in England. Right? Then commercial. Yes, Srishti?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you were saying something. Nothing?
Sir, am I audible now, sir?
Yeah, your voice is breaking. That's why. Yeah, you are.
My network is highly unstable.
Oh, okay, now the voice is clear. Yeah, you are saying something.
National societies in England. I think.
What?
National Dahlia Society. It's in England, I think, sir.
Yes. The National Dahlia Society is located at England, right? Then moving to other points. As I told, tree dahlia is Dahlia imperialis. Then, which is the ancestor of Dahlia? Progenitor is Dahlia variabilis. The main problem with respect to breeding is self incompatibility. I think you know what you mean by self incompatibility. This will promote the cross pollination in Dahlia. This is the major constraint in breeding program. To induce more flowering in Dahlia, we'll apply GA3. To reduce the plant height in Dahlia, we'll use malic hydroxide, then psychosil. These are the two chemicals used for the reduction of the plant growth. Then disbudding, disshooting is done at P stage, means when the buds are in small stage.
Sir, malic hydroxide used for?
Malic hydroxide and psychosil are used for the reduction of plant height in Dahlia. These are all generally used in the for the reduction of plant height. Malic hydroxide is widely used for the reducing the plant height, and psychosis also, right? And major air pollutant for the Dahlia, if the sulfur dioxide is more in the air, the leaves will become chlorosis. The major disease will be powdery mildew. Then which is the satisfactory method which is developed in India for the flower preservation? Means if the option is late cutting, go for that. The important breeders in Dahlia, mainly Swami Vinayananda, then P.K. Das, then Glory of India, Nearest Blue, Prime Minister. These are all the important varieties in Dahlia. Then Sectorial Chimera Mutant, Manali. You remember this one? Sectorial Chimera Mutant. Then natural mutant will be Genita. Okay. With respect to lawn, you know which is a shade tolerant grass species? Or cool season? Shade tolerant is Saint Augustine or Joysia japonica. Cool season is Kentucky bluegrass, Poya. This is also cool season one, right? Then who given the name Dahlia? These are all in-depth question, I think. Abbe Cavanilis, A B B E, Abbe C A V A NILLES. This scientist given the name Dahlia. Then usually in the initially, why they named like that? Because the stems were hollow. They were also called as hollow pipes or water tubes. Hollow stems. Then any other points? This tuber, Dahlia tubers consist insulin and fructose. Then this insulin extracted from the Dahlia mainly used for the diagnosis of renal function. Renal is a particular part or the organ in the human excretory system. In the nearby kidney it will be there. Mainly this insulin extracted from the Dahlia is used for the diagnosis of renal function. You remember this one, okay? This is also important one. And one more key point is Dahlia pinnata. This is a species, Dahlia pinnata, have the nematicidal property. Hence, this is used for the, used as a intercrop or the trap crop in the cabbage or cauliflower nurseries. You remember this one. Got it? Dahlia pinnata has the nematicidal property used in the cabbage and cauliflower nursery as a trap crop. The best quality of plants were obtained when the day temperature is 25 degrees Celsius and the night temperature is 16 degrees Celsius. Okay, the commercially propagated by vegetative means, by division of tubers or by division of apical or terminal cuttings. Easiest way is division of tubers. Then the sulfur dioxide is the major air pollutant in Dahlia. It causes the chlorosis. Dahlia rosea, you remember this one. Dahlia rosea is a indicator plant for SO2. This is also important one. Dahlia rosea is an indicator plant for SO2. Then the cultivar Junita, as we earlier discussed, it's a natural mutant. Manali is a sectorial chimera from white pearl. What do you mean by RAHS? They may ask in the objective type questions. We have earlier discussed now itself, some 2 to 3 times. We discussed now. RAHS. RAHS. What do you mean by RAHS? Yeah, any one of you? RAHS. Royal Agricultural and Horticulture Society of India. Located at Kolkata. So please be remember this one. Dahlia is self-incompatible. Hence, it promotes the cross-pollination. Bees are the main pollinators in Dahlia. Then any other doubts or any other points to add for this discussion? Yes? Yes, Ankita, Varanya, Deb?
Yes, sir.
Any other points to add for this discussion?
A sectorial chimera mutant means?
What do you mean by sectorial chimera mutant? That is a question, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, if you consider,
yes.
Yeah, if you consider a tissue, I think you well known with the what do you mean by mutation, how the mutation is done. Usually a part of tissue is taken for the mutation or the whole like say for example the apical bud or the terminal cutting. This cutting is kept for the mutation under the gamma irradiation or for or any other chemical mutant. It will act on the tissues on the outer layer of the explant. If you consider a cell, one sec. If you consider a cell, let it be consider this round cell. If the cell is exposed for the mutagen, if the mutation or anything new appeared on the sectorial portion of that explant, only a small portion of that explant is expresses the a new variant or a new cultivar or new variation of that species. Say for example, it will produce the very large flowers with a pinkish red colored blooms. So this sectorial part is extracted from that part of explant. Say for example, this is a, we kept terminal cutting. We will extract that sectorial part from that terminal cutting, and this part will be budded or tissue cultured or say any other means we will propagate that explant. This will produce the new mutant or the new variation in the this dahlia flower crop or any other flower crop. This is the mutation, how it works. You got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then any other doubts, queries?
So facultative short day meaning?
Facultative short day. Mainly this dahlia is facultative short day. Facultative short day means short day. What do you mean by short day? Short day means if any crop requires less than 12 hours of shade daylight, then it will going to flower. Under the short day condition only it will going to flower. Otherwise, if it is exposed for the day neutral or long day, it will continuously go for the vegetative growth. It will only flowers when it falls under less than 12 hours of sunlight. This is what we call short day plant. Facultative short day means it will going to flower in the day neutral or in the long day condition, but the yield of the crop like dahlia, it will going to yield very less. It is under stress, so it will be yield very low volume of flowers. It will going to give the flowers in under the stress in order to survive. But it is basically a short day plant like that. It will going to flower in the day neutral or long day condition only under the stress condition. But the yield will be very low. This is mainly due to stress. Hence it is strictly a short day plant. That's why it is called as facultative short day plant. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Further? Further, any doubts? If it is the case, then we will close the meeting then. We'll see in the next class.
Okay, sir.
Which crop do you want in the next class? We'll deal with the chainaster. Chainaster is okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Then we'll discuss the next session on chainaster. Okay then, fine. Okay, see you then. Take care. Bye bye.